Hello students, I hope you guys must be enjoying this time. I am your chemistry teacher and I welcome you to my chemistry channel, that is Amazing Chemistry. So today I am going to discuss an important topic, a very preliminary topic for the class 11th, as you guys can see, that is the type of carbon atoms, general organic chemistry for class 11th. Starting with the first topic, that is type of carbon atoms. So there are four types of carbon atoms. As you guys can see, this is primary. First is primary carbon, that is 1 degree. Second is secondary carbon atom, 2 degree. Third one is tertiary carbon atom, 3 degree. And the fourth one is quaternary, 4 degree. So now I'm going to discuss one by one. What is primary carbon, that is 1 degree carbon? What is secondary, that is 2 degree carbon? What is tertiary, 3 degree carbon, and what is quaternary, 4 degree carbon. So hope you guys will enjoy this video. So one by one I'm going to explain that what is 1 degree. Here you can see this carbon. When the carbon is attached to the carbon atom which is having 4 hydrogen atom, so this is an example of 1 degree carbon. Here I have written propane. So here CH3, CH2, CH3. So the carbon atom which is attached with 3 hydrogen atom is known as primary carbon or 1 degree carbon atom. So here both the carbon atom like this one or this one, which is surrounded by 3 hydrogen atom and second carbon, is known as primary carbon or 1 degree carbon. Now coming on to the second one, that is secondary carbon atom. This is the example of 2 degree carbon. Here you can see, because here this carbon is attached to 2 carbon atom, so this carbon is known as secondary carbon atom or 2 degree carbon atom. Coming on to the next, that is tertiary carbon atom, or we can say is the 3 degree carbon. Here this carbon is attached with a 3 carbon group, so it is known as tertiary carbon. Here I have given one more example of this one also. Look at this carbon. This carbon is attached with a 3 carbon group, 3 methyl group. So this carbon is known as tertiary carbon atom. So first one is primary, which is surrounded by, like the 4 valency of this carbon is by hydrogen. 3 hydrogen atoms are there, which is actually attached to the carbon atom. So all the 3 valencies are satisfied with this 3 hydrogen atom. So this carbon is known as 1 degree carbon. Second one is secondary, that is 2 degree carbon. And third one is 3 degree carbon. So now coming on to the next one, that is quaternary carbon atom or 4 degree, in which the carbon atom, all the 4 valencies of carbon has been satisfied by with the 4 carbon atom. So here you can see this carbon is attached with the 4 ethyl group. So this type of carbon is known as quaternary carbon atom or 4 degree carbon atom. Now coming on to the next topic, that is types of carbon chains. So first one is the straight chain, like always we call the straight chain where we have straight number of alkyl chain, like n-pentane, n-butane. Here is the example, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there is a long carbon chain of 5 carbon atoms. So this is known as n-pentane. Similarly, the 4 carbon atom chain is n-butane. So alkane containing continuous chain of atom called as straight chain alkane or normal n-alkane. We can represent it with n-alkane also. So now you guys can take a snapshot of this topic, that different carbon atom, 1 degree, 2 degree, 3 degree, 4 degree, primary, secondary, tertiary and quaternary, and then types of carbon chain. First one is straight chain, and the example of straight chain is n-pentane or n-butane. Now jump on to the next topic, that what I have written over here, that if first and the last carbon has alkyl group, then also it is considered as a straight chain. Alright, now the next topic is branched chain alkane, that is isoalkane. Here I have given the example, here like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so on second and fourth carbon we have done the methyl group. So this is a chain, this is the example of chain alkane. Here I have given one more example, here you can see this propane, a straight chain on which there is a branching of a methyl group. So when a methyl group, we cannot write the alkyl, the right word is methyl only. When a methyl group is present at the second और सेकंड लास्ट कार्बन एटम ऑफ अ नॉर्मल एल्केन इट इज नोन एज आइसो एल्केन. ऑल राइट, लाइक आइसो ब्यूटेन, दिस इज द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ आइसो ब्यूटेन. कमिंग ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, दैट इज नियो एल्केन ऑन कार्बन चेन, दैट इज ऑन द सेकंड एंड द सेकंड लास्ट कार्बन द टू मिथाइल ग्रुप इज अटैच, देन द ग्रुप इज नोन एज नियो एल्केन. द एग्जाम्पल इज न्यू, दिस इज द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ नियोहेप्टेन, बिकॉज हियर द टोटल नंबर ऑफ कार्बन एटम इज 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And on the second group, there's a 3-methyl group. So this is known as 2-methyl groups are present on this. So it is known as neoheptane. This is the example of neohexane because here the total number of carbon atom is 6. As you can see, there are 2-methyl group on this second carbon. So this is known as neoalkane. The term is used neoalkane. And why we are using the term hexane? Because there are total 6 carbon atoms. So this is the example of neoalkane. First one is isoalkane. So I have given the example of isobutane. In this I have given the example of neoheptane and neohexane. Now jump on to the next one. That is alkyl. What is alkyl group? So as we all know that the formula of alkane is CnH2n plus 2. So when one hydrogen has been removed from this group, so that group is known as alkyl chain. After removal of one hydrogen atom group obtained from the corresponding alkane, then we call the group is known as alkyl. Example like RH is used for the for alkane we use RH straight chain, and one hydrogen has been removed from this alkane, we use the term alkyl chain. Like for methane, the formula of methane is CH4. When one hydrogen has been removed, it is known as methyl group. Similarly for propane, when one hydrogen has been removed, it is known as propyl group. Now there's one question. So here I'm going to discuss a small question that all N iso and neo alkyl groups are primary, that is 1 degree, except isopropyl, which is a secondary. So why is it so? I'm going to define it later on this video. Now coming on to the same topic, that what is N-alkyl, here I've given the example of N-propane containing 3 hydrogen atom. When there's a removal of one carbon from this, one hydrogen from this, then we use the term N-propyl. So here you can see, this is the formula of N-propane, CnH2n plus 2. But when one hydrogen has been removed, this is the N-propyl and it is primary, this is 1 degree carbon. Alright, now coming on to the next one, that is isoalkyl. Here I've given the example of isobutane. As you can see, there are 4 carbon atom, and this carbon has been here. This group is known as iso. This is the iso. Now the next one is, when one hydrogen has been removed from this methyl group, this group is known as isobutyl group. Similarly, if I talk about neoalkyl, when converting iso and neoalkane into iso and neoalkyl, hydrogen has been removed, such that an iso and neo structure unit is intact in corresponding alkyl group. So the basic moiety will remain same, only the hydrogen atom gets removed from the methyl group. So the basic property will remain same, that is why it is known as isoalkyl or neoalkyl. The examples are isobutyl or neobutyl. Now here I have given few examples, like from the 1 degree carbon, here you can see this is a 1 degree carbon atom, this is 1 degree carbon atom. So when one hydrogen has been removed from this, because the neo group remained the same, only one hydrogen has been replaced. So it is known as the one hydrogen has been moved out from this group. So this group is known as neopentyl, as it contains 5 carbon atom. Similarly, N-propyl group, isopropyl, this is the example of isopropyl. Now what is the difference between isopropyl and secondary? So here I have given the example, here you can see this is the formula of isopropyl, because there are 3 carbon atom and the hydrogen has been removed from the center carbon. So this is the example of isopropyl group. Now moving on to the next, that is example of secondary alkyl. This carbon is the secondary carbon, here the hydrogen has been removed from this carbon atom, so this is secondary alkyl group. You can take a snapshot from this. Now coming on to few tertiary alkyl groups. As I already described regarding the isoalkyl, neoalkyl, now the topic is tertiary alkyl group. So this is the tertiary carbon atom. So here you can see when one hydrogen has been removed from the tertiary carbon, this group is known as tertiary alkyl group. This one is the example of isobutyl. As I already mentioned, this is isobutyl, this is secondary butyl. You can see the difference between the two structure. Although the number of carbon atom remain the same, but from here only hydrogen has been removed from this, the iso group remain the same. Whereas if we talk about the secondary, here you can see the methyl group is on the side carbon. So this is the difference between the isobutyl and the secondary butyl. You guys need to write down multiple times. You have to practice it and you have to do multiple questions, then only this fundamental will be clear for you. Write down all the example which I have given. It is very important. This is a basic thing. The concept has to be clear that on which group we have to use iso group, for which we have to use secondary. So these are the concepts which are very important for 11th class. Coming on to the next, that is neopentyl. Here you can see this is the formula for a neopentyl group. Now the third one is tertiary pentyl group. So this is the formula for a tertiary pentyl. So now moving on to the next topic, that three-dimensional representation of an organic molecule. You must have seen there are certain structures on which this dash and wedge has been given. So this dark color representation of a bond, it shows that the atom which has been presented by this bond, like it is coming away from you and it comes towards you, that group. If we use this dark bond using the solid line, so it represents that the group is coming towards you, towards the person who is observing. And the wedge, it shows that the atom which is attached through this bond, it goes away from the carbon atom on the back side of the paper. And if it is represented by a symbol, only by a simple line, then this bond is on the plane of the paper. So there are three representations. First, by this line, this is also considered as a bond. This one is also a bond, and this is also a presentation of a bond. But there's a different, it shows the plane of the paper, it shows towards the observer, it shows away from the observer. So this is the representation of an organic molecule. As I have written, three-dimensional 3D structure of an organic molecule can be represented on a paper by using solid and dash wedge formula for this presentation of a group. Now coming on to the last topic for today lesson, that is classification of an organic compound. So it is classified on the basis of structure and on the basis of functional group. So first we talk about the classification on the basis of structure. So it can be distinguished into two forms, that is open chain structure and the closed chain. Open chain we call open chain like acyclic or aliphatic. Aliphatic is open chain ring, and closed ring like ring chain or the cyclic chain. So now talking about the open chain, that is acyclic and aliphatic, further it is divided into two parts. First is straight chain, as we talk about n-pentane, n-butane, n-hexane, n-heptane. And if we are doing the branching, then this kind of carbon chain is known as branch chain structure. Example is isopentane. So now coming on to the next one, that is closed chain. So here you can see I have given a very good distinguished structure. You can take a snapshot also that how to classify the organic compounds. First is on the basis of open chain and the closed chain. Further, open chain has been divided into two parts, that is straight chain or the branching. Now coming on to the closed chain, is further distinguished into two parts, that is alicyclic and aromatic. As we all know, the example of aromatic compound is like benzene, so it is considered as a homoaromatic. However, if there is some function, if there is any carbon atom has been replaced by any other atom like nitrogen, oxygen, then it is considered as a heteroaromatic. These type of compounds are also known as heteroaromatic compounds or heterocyclic compounds. However, if we talk about the alicyclic, there are two. It is further divided into two parts, that is homoalicyclic, which is having symmetry. However, if the carbon atom has been replaced by any other heteroatoms like oxygen, sulfur, nitrogen, then this kind of a cyclic structure is known as heterocyclic compounds. The example is tetrahydrofuran, THF. the example of homoalicyclic is cyclohexene. So you guys can take a snapshot of this. I hope you guys must learn from this chapter. It is a very important topic for class 11th, and you can refer your NCERT book also. All the notes which has been uploaded by me is strictly based on NCERT. And now coming on to the next one, that is the classification of organic compound on the basis of functional groups. There are multiple functional groups which you guys are going to study in class 12th and further also. So coming on to the functional group classification, if the hydrogen atom has been replaced by the hydroxy group, then that group is known as alcohol. Example is methanol. Now coming on to the next one, that is carboxylic acid. If the hydrogen atom has been replaced and the new group that has been attached is COOH, so this COOH is known as carboxylic group. This is an example of ethanoic acid because two carbon chain is there, so we used term ethanoic. Or the commercial name of this compound is acetic acid. Moving on to when the hydrogen atom has been replaced by any halogen group like chloro, bromo, iodo, so then this kind of a compound has been formed, which is known as alkyl halide. Here I have given the example of chloromethane. So this is general terminology used for this compound is alkyl halide. So the class that has been characterized by an atom or a group of atom which determine the structure and the property of the compounds are called functional groups. Here I have given the list of functional groups that we are going to study in class 11th in the coming chapters. First one is the alkane. The general formula is CnH2n+2. Alkene, which contains double bond. Alkyne, which contains triple bond. Now the alkyl halide, this X group represent the halogen group like fluoro, chloro, bromo, iodo. And if the hydrogen has been replaced by the hydroxy group, then this compound is known as alcohol. This group is known as alcohol group. Moving on to the aromatic hydroxy, that is phenol. So AR here it represents the aromatic group. This is the ether when the oxygen has been, where the two alkyl chain and there is one oxygen atom in between. This kind of a functional group is known as ether. Next one is aldehyde. Here you can see this group is aldehydic group where the alkyl R represent the alkyl chain, R, C double bond O and H. There is a double bond between carbon and oxygen atom. So this is known as aldehyde group. Moving on to the next one. When there is a, in spite of this hydrogen, there is an alkyl group. So this compound is known as ketone. As I already discussed, carboxylic group. When there is a C double bond OOH is attached to the alkyl chain, this kind of a functional group is known as carboxylic acid. However, when this hydrogen gets replaced by the alkyl chain, this group is known as ester. Moreover, when this compound, this hydroxy group get replaced by the halide, then this kind of a functional group is known as halide. When this OH is replaced by amine, so this entire group is known as amide. So this is acid amide, this one is acid halide, this group is esters. So all these functional groups and their properties, their synthesis, we are going to study in the coming chapters in class 11th and in class 12th also. So these are very important to have a good concept. You write down all these group on the paper and just practice it as much as you can, and you have to memorize the group. Moreover, the concept will be more clear once you have all the structures in your mind, and once anybody can ask you about what is the ether group. So you need to be very clear about the groups, that what is the functional group, what is the representation of this functional group. So you guys please take a snapshot of this. Now there are certain other functional groups like amine, cyano, isocyanide, nitro. So NO2 is a nitro group. Here R, wherever I have written the R represent the alkyl chain. It could be methane, ethane, ethyl group, methyl group, propyl. So I have written R over here. So don't get confused by this R. This R actually represent the alkyl chain. So the other functional groups like amine, cyano, isocyanide, nitro and nitrite. So this is the last topic for this day. So I'm going to complete this video. I hope you guys must enjoy this video and it is going to be very helpful for you. And thank you so much. Please subscribe my channel and like my channel. I have uploaded multiple videos in the coming time. So I hope you guys must learn from these videos. So for motivating me, please keep sharing and keep liking my channel and subscribe my channel. Thank you so much once again. Your chemistry teacher, Dr. Rohit. Goodbye. Thank you. Take care.